We are testing a Samsung Galaxy A80, a mid-high range device. The first step is to press the power button for half a second to observe the current value. The device has not been used before, so after pressing the button 3 times, the consumption reached 350 milliamperes. We continue with the boot cycle and we see that after rising to 700 milliamperes, the device remains with the fixed consumption or half an ampere. This is because the device is looking for updates, so we have to wait to see what happens. We continue in fast camera while the device is working with peaks of 1.8 to 2 amperes, since it's the high-end device, so the processor and memory have to perform a lot of operation per second. After the high current, the device has to lower the processes and disable some circuits so that it finally enters in power saving mode. To understand the boot cycle of this device, the best way is to update it, as it has been 3.5 years without use. This will allow us to draw our conclusion and repeat the processes over and over again to understand the operation of the mobile device logically. The boot process of the device not only requires a good understanding of technology, but also a good understanding of the energy-saving mechanisms, as well as the ability to identify and solve hard, soft, and system failures. Therefore, it is important to understand the boot cycle of the phone so that you can be able to fix it. The truth is that it's nothing out of the ordinary, and today we have tools such as a thermal camera and the Rosin technique, which help us a lot to make good diagnosis. I imagined that the device needed an update. For this reason, the phone has remained with a fixed consumption of 500 milliamperes for a couple of minutes. We are going to see the boot cycle in fast camera and observe how it ends. Depending on the phone configuration, after 1 or 2 minutes, the device will have to shut down the processes and enter in power saving mode. At the end of the process, we can see how the current is getting smaller and smaller, and when we press the power button, the device reactivates. To learn to repair mobile devices, you have to do it with logic and not memorize values, consumption, and things like this. Remember that in electronics, never 1 + 1 = 2. At first, it will cost you to understand some failures, but then, little by little, your experience will help you a lot to repair more and more devices. In the first week, you'll be able to repair 4 out of 10 devices, then 5 out of 10, and little by little, you'll go up in level. No face-to-face or online courses will prepare a technician to repair 10 out of 10 devices in 1 week. This, yes, for the first day you will be able to get a good income with each repair, and in less than an hour you can receive the salary of 1 or 2 days of work. 6 or 7 years ago, repairing in my house, I charged about 3 or even 4,000 euros a month. For this reason, I decide to open a store of 100 square meters and hire people to support me with this project. The trick is never to lose the illusion and keep working hard to achieve your goals. Today, in our laboratory, we have repairs for a cost of more than 120 euros and a time of approximately 1 hour. I know many technicians who, in less than a year, have reached a high level as long as they have worked very hard. In this life, nobody wants to give money away, so it depends on us to find the easiest way to get it. I can only show you the way, the rest depends on you. For example, a motherboard repair usually does not have many expenses, and any integrated circuit or any capacitor can be recycled for a broken motherboard that you will accumulate over the months.